guys, welcome back for a brand new round of box office predictions. As always, we're kicking off this video with the recap, and it's an interesting recap for good and bad reasons this week. First, for the good is how many perfect lineups we had in Fantasy Movie League. In the predictions with Perri League, there were 37 in total. All the names are up on the screen right now. As always, I must say, job well done, guys. I am very impressed that you guys knew that Midway was being undervalued on Fantasy Movie League because, hey, that helped score you the big win. So congratulations to everyone. As for my rankings last week, hey, they weren't good. And you know, that happens sometimes. Yeah, I like to be right. Who doesn't? But it can't always pan out, especially when you take the risk of betting on something every single week. So every once in a while, especially when a little bit of an anomaly happens with Dr. Sleep kind of crashing and burning, it's bound to happen that I swing and miss. And I most certainly did this week. I think the thing that upsets me most about the results, though, is just how poorly the box office is doing right now. Not just Dr. Sleep. We've had a lot of misses recently, and hey, that's a bummer, but it is a big bummer in particular with Dr. Sleep because, as some of you know, I am a big fan of that movie, and when I see good filmmaking, I keep my fingers crossed that it is rewarded, and that was not the case for Dr. Sleep this weekend, but a whole bunch of you out there saw and really enjoyed Midway because that movie scored an A cinema score and the top spot on the charts this time around. It made $17.9 million for its opening weekend, a solid start compared to the competition, but that $100 million production budget is a little bit of a hefty price tag to earn back. Then it was Dr. Sleep at number two, which turned out to be the big bust for Warner Brothers, coming in well below expectations with just $14.1 million. Newcomer Playing With Fire, however, did top my expectations, making $12.7 million, which was good enough for the number three spot because another new release that I did have faith in didn't do as well as I thought. Last Christmas kicked off its run with a kind of lackluster $11.3 million. And then finally, we had Terminator Dark Fate, which, as expected, did take a very big hit. It dipped nearly 63% and made another $10.8 million. All right, let's try to improve my rankings this time around. But I do have to point out right off the top here is that given how things have been going, I might be a little conservative with my totals this week. And when it comes to the number five position, I'm not going to give it to The Good Liar. That's one of the newcomers. I don't think it's going to make enough to crack the top five. I'm eyeing Dr. Sleep and Playing With Fire for four and five, though. And much to my, I guess, disappointment, I'm actually going to put Playing With Fire above Dr. Sleep, which means my number five this time around is Dr. Sleep. All is not entirely lost with this one, though, because even though it had a very, very small opening total, it does have a B-plus cinema score, and it's also got a 90% audience score on Rotten Tomatoes, and I think that those are signs that there's going to be some good word of mouth, which, hey, at least it could hold on a little to what it had last week, and even though it's not all that much. And, you know, I'm just thinking about some other horror releases that came out and made a somewhat similar amount of cash opening weekend. And I'm thinking that if a movie like Escape Room can hold on to half of its opening weekend profits, so should Dr. Sleep. And if Dr. Sleep takes a 50% hit in weekend two, it's still taking another $7 million to the bank this time around. Now we're making our way over to number four. And of course, that is where I have Playing With Fire. I think the fact that we are inching closer to the holiday season, to Thanksgiving specifically, bodes very well for a family-friendly movie like Playing With Fire. And so does the comp that I have my eye on right now. And that particular comp is Goosebumps 2 Haunted Halloween. And I'm thinking that the percent change trend for that movie could be a very good sign for Playing With Fire. It opens with a little more than $15.8 million, not too much higher than Playing With Fire. And then weekend two, it only fell a mere 38.5%. I do think a drop like that is somewhat reasonable for Playing With Fire, maybe wanting to bring it up just the slightest bit. And even if that is the case, Playing With Fire could still top Dr. Sleep and take that four spot with about $8 million this weekend. We're working our way up the charts now to the number three position, and this time around, I'm giving that spot to Midway. I do think the fact that this movie opened up on Veterans Day weekend helped it big time last weekend, but I also think that A cinema score is a sign that it's got a chance to hold strong this time around. Also, the first comp that came to my mind is Hacksaw Ridge, and that could be a very good thing for this movie. So Hacksaw Ridge, it also got an A cinema score. It opened up in early November, and it opened up with about $15 million. Things that are not similar between the two, though, Hacksaw Ridge had Oscar buzz. Midway does not. And then on top of that, I have to account for the fact that Midway does have a little more to lose here. So if I take the week and 2% change Hacksaw Ridge saw, 30%, and decide to bring it up a little, maybe to 40%, that still means Midway is making another $10.5 million this weekend. We have hit the number two spot now, and that is where I have one of our new big, not so big releases of the weekend. This is where I have Charlie's Angels. Some of you know I have seen the movie, and quality-wise, it exceeded my expectations, but I still don't think that's going to translate to big box office numbers at all. The 2000 Charlie's Angels movie opened up with a rock-solid $40 million. Then the sequel did pretty well, too. It made $37.6 million. This new one, though, is going to be lucky to make half that. I don't even think it's going to make half that. Looking at a comp for this, I'm going straight to the Pitch Perfect franchise, another franchise that Elizabeth Banks is involved in. First one did well. Second one did well. And then lessening interest led to a weak start for the third one, roughly $20 million. But still, even though those numbers kept dipping, Pitch Perfect 3 has one advantage over Charlie's Angels right now, and it's the fact that it hit theaters right around Christmas time. And not only is it not a holiday weekend for Charlie's Angels, but it's also hitting theaters at a very disappointing time for the box office. So that number has to come down. I think I'm going to bring it down $5, $6 million and give Charlie's Angels an opening total of $14 million. That brings us to the top spot, the movie that could breathe a little life into this box office. My number one pick this week is Ford v. Ferrari. I have seen a very wide range of projections for this one. I hear Disney is being super conservative and they're saying something like the high teens. I've seen numbers in the 20s, and I've seen some saying it could crack $30 million this weekend. I kind of lean towards being a little more conservative just because of how recent releases are doing, and I'm not really sure this one's going to be a big, big hit. Also, when I take into account the fact that a lot of the movies that Disney is distributing that they got from Fox, they're not doing very well this year. So that kind of led me to at least start with First Man for comps. That movie came out late in the year. It had a whole bunch of Oscar buzz, and it opened up with $16 million. The thing is, though, it was dealing with very strong weekend twos for both Venom and A Star Is Born. So I think the number has to come up from that. And then I eye something like Captain Phillips, which I think could appeal to a very similar audience. And that, to me, seems like the way to go. I actually think Ford v. Ferrari could wind up matching that movie's total. And that would mean I have Ford v. Ferrari topping the charts with about $26 million. And again, I know some are predicting higher than that, but given what the November box office has looked like thus far, I'm just hesitant to go any higher than that right now. Let's recap these predictions. Ford v. Ferrari is my number one with $26 million. Then I have Charlie's Angels opening up at number two with $14 million. Midway taking the three spot with $10.5 million. Then it's Playing with Fire, taking $8 million, just topping Dr. Sleep, which I have at number five with $7 million. That's it for me this time around. Fingers crossed I get a more accurate top five. You know what I like you to do. Hit the comments below. Put your top five suggestions right there. Go on over to Fantasy Movie League and lock those lineups. The season is winding down. The competition is fierce, and I am determined to be in the top 50 at the end of it. Before I say goodbye, it's Patreon shout-out time. We got a great group of six here. It's Charles, Craig, Ryan, Paul, Andrew, and Corey. Longtime patrons right here, and I appreciate you guys so, so much. You guys having my back month to month really means the world to me, so thank you so much for being here. And thanks to everybody out there watching these videos. Do not forget to like and share this one, and tune in next week to see how we all did on our box office predictions.